All right, for today's problem of the day, I think this is a tricky one. We're gonna find the domain and range of this function. And the specific domain rule that we need to remember for this problem is that if we have something under an even root, and in this case we have a square root, so that is an even root, the thing under that even root has to be greater than or equal to zero. What that tells us mathematically for this problem is that 25 minus x squared, the thing under the even root, has to be greater than or equal to zero. Well, there are a lot of ways to finish this problem. Let's start by trying to get x by itself. We're gonna add x squared to both sides of this inequality. That gives us 25 is greater than or equal to x squared, which is the same thing as writing x squared is less than or equal to 25. One way to complete this problem in this fashion would be to take the square root of both sides of this inequality. However, if we do it this way, we have to remember that the square root of x squared is actually the absolute value of x, so we get the absolute value of x is less than or equal to 5. From here, we would have to remember our rules for inequalities, which say that if we have this absolute value here, we can split this problem up, and x basically has to be sandwiched in between negative 5 and 5. Now, this does give us the domain for this function. We could have branched off here, and instead of doing that algebraically, we could have just thought to ourselves, what x values would satisfy this inequality? And if you think long enough and hard enough about it, you should come to the conclusion that x has to be less than or equal to 5, but x also has to be greater than or equal to negative 5 in order for the square of this x to be less than 25. So you could have just done that in your head with a little thought bubble here. One more way to look at this problem, if we started back here with 25 minus x squared is greater than or equal to 0, we could have thought of 25 minus x squared as a parabola that opens downwards and has its vertex all the way up here at 25. A little bit of investigation would lead you to the fact that this parabola's zeros or roots occur at x equals 5 and x equals negative 5. So the values of x for which this function here are greater than or equal to 0 occur between x equals negative 5 and x equals positive 5. That's the same answer we just got using these other two techniques. Okay, so maybe short story long there, we got a domain which we can write in interval notation as negative 5 to 5 with brackets. We are using brackets again because of these little equal signs. If we did not have those little equal signs there, we would be using parentheses. Okay, so that's the domain. What about the range? Well, to get the range of a function, what we really need is a graph of it. You could graph this on your graphing calculator, or if you'd like to do this without a graphing calculator, you could call this function y. You could square both sides of this equation, and you could add x squared to both sides of this equation, and you might realize that this function is actually a circle, or more specifically, a semicircle. Because this here is a function, it needs to pass the vertical line test, so a circle isn't kosher here. Because you'll notice there's not a plus or minus in front of the square root, we're just taking the half of the circle whose y values are positive. So anyway, you can see from this graph that the range or the y values of this function go from y equals 0 all the way up to y equals 5. So our range is 0 to 5. Okay, let me zoom out on that. I hope that helps you out with that problem, and I'll see you next time for the next problem of the day.